Good evening. Sports, say the ancient Greeks, is morally serious because mankind's noblest aim is the loving contemplation of worthy things. That's an excerpt from my new book on baseball entitled Men at Work. And I would say it's particularly apropos in light of today's Expo Padre game. Joining me today are two gentlemen who would no doubt agree. First, former slugger for the Philadelphia Phillies, Mike Schmidt. Good day, Mike. Tell us, what do you miss most since retiring from baseball last year?
Well, George, I guess I miss going to the ballpark every day.
Yes, ballparks. In humanity, there exists a vestigial memory of an enclosed green space as a place or freedom or play.
Yeah. I guess.
Excellent. Competing with Mr. Schmidt today is skillful practitioner of the managerial arts from the Dodgers, Tommy Lasorda. Salutations, Tommy.
Good to see you, George. I'm ready to play.
Well, the manager's role is one of both Hector and Helper, naysayer and nexus. Around his circumference lies the full measure of the game.
I'm ready to play.
Very well, let us engage the sports machine. Gentlemen, as always, the questions will focus exclusively on baseball, the only game that transcends the boundary between fury and repose. All right, hands on buzzers. The precarious balance between infield and outfield suggests a perfect symmetry. For $50, identify the effect of that symmetry. Sorry, the answer is the exhilarating tension between being and becoming. Being and becoming. Next question. In 1954, Willie Mays, in an emphatic stroke of Byzantine whimsy, made his over-the-shoulder catch off Vic Wertz. What was it not unlike? Take it. Anyone?
The catch in Cincinnati.
It was not unlike watching Atlantis rise again from the sea, the bones of its kings new covered with flesh. Well, gentlemen, no score as of yet, but the night is young. Perhaps what you gentlemen need is a little incentive. So here to tell you about today's prize is our own Sam Donaldson.
Thank you, George. Thank you. Today's winner will receive copies of Roget's Expanded Thesaurus. Buy me a Roget's and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if I never come back. And they'll also receive Choco Whip, chocolate-favored whip topping. It's sweet and fluffy. Choco Whip.
Sam, isn't it somewhat of a given that a whip topping would be sweet and fluffy?
Oh, come off it, George. You can't see the forest for the trees.
We'll continue this spirited discussion later. As for now, it's time we moved on to the big board. And the categories are baseball as narrative, Aristotle and Comiskey, Joyce Carol Oates, left field myth or monopoeia, pitch, patch, potch, Dolce a decorum est, and potluck. Mike, choose a category.
Potluck.
Very well. Like freedom, baseball is that state where energy and order merge, and all complexity is purified into a simple coherence. Piffle or not piffle.
Piffle.
That is correct. It's absolute piffle. It's baseball's complexity, not its purity, that instills in us our freedom. And you have $100.
Hey, wait a minute! What's this piffle crap? What kind of question is that?
I'm sorry, Tommy, but this is not a forum here for debating the merits of...
No, this isn't a joke here. I'm playing for a bunch of kids in a hospital. You're making me look like a chump.
I feel kind of stupid, too.
Everything in good time, gentlemen. Yeah, you simply need to...
Let me ask you something. You ever play baseball?
If If by play you mean drink deep the aura of the game, then...
No, no, I mean play the game in the field, in the field. Here, throw this ball.
I'm sorry, Mr. Lasorda, but my duties as quizmaster compel me to move the game along.
Throw the ball, George! Throw the ball!
Shut up, Sam. Now then. Next question. Mike, you have control of the board.
Throw the ball! Come on, throw the ball!
Throw the ball!
Throw the ball!
Throw the ball!
Throw